One man, one mission, to rid the world of chronic anxiety once and for all. The Anxiety Guy, Dennis Simsek, shares his personal transformation from living a life filled with overwhelming worry to becoming a full-fledged positivity machine, a leading authority in generalized anxiety. Dennis gets to the truth of your mental health challenges and sets you on a path to transforming each and every area of your life. Here he is, the one and only, the Anxiety Guy.
Warrior, welcome to episode number 116 of the Anxiety Guy podcast. On the show today, I'll be talking about living with anxiety and perfectionism, something that so many people today are going through, the cycle, not recognizing where it comes from, what keeps it going, and so forth. So today I'm going to be tackling this issue so that you can see whether or not perfectionism is causing you or someone you know further anxiety, further weight on their shoulders, further heaviness in their lives. We're going to make that person a little bit lighter today to examine this and to go a little bit deeper into perfectionism. Now, perfectionism is perceived as being equal to happiness, success, and achievement for so many people. They believe that if they're not perfect, if they do not practice perfectionism, that they are failing. They will be unhappy or unsuccessful or not achieve certain things in their lives. In my opinion, perfectionism in today's world comes from an idea way back in childhood that by being perfect, the child gains a parent's love or meets another human need. Can you relate to that? It also increases their chances of survival. Now, I'm not talking about life or death survival. I'm talking about social acceptance. I'm talking about education. I'm talking about athleticism. Since we don't have saber-toothed tigers running after us in today's world, when we talk about survival, we're talking about these perspectives, these aspects of life. We're talking about social interaction. We're talking about education, job, career, acceptance from other people, all these sorts of things. This is life or death for us. So, do you have this opinion that was ingrained, embedded into you from childhood? Maybe not verbally, maybe not through words or instructions, but more so through behaviors, because as a child, we pick up on behaviors so much when it comes to our authority figures. And when we pick these up, we begin to implement them thinking that this is the right way to be. And therefore, with repetition, it becomes ingrained into us. And all of a sudden, we're kind of like our authority figure, which in our world is a good thing. Until we start questioning it. But too many people today are not questioning their behaviors. They're not questioning their core beliefs. What we are not told about perfectionism is that there is a difference between aiming to be perfect and striving for excellence or self-mastery. Perfectionism is about wanting to meet our goals, to please or impress other people. Whereas striving for excellence is about achieving your goals to please yourself and better your self-worth. Can you see the difference? Healthy striving is internally motivated, and perfectionism is externally motivated. Let me say that again. Healthy striving and progress is internally motivated, and perfectionism is externally motivated. What is also problematic about perfectionism is that one's self-worth is based on the ability to achieve the unrealistic goal. So, if they do not achieve the unrealistic goals, all of a sudden, they view themselves, they label themselves as being not worthy of companionship, of a certain amount of abundance in their lives, of happiness and so forth. So, what drives and underlies the perfectionist mindset? Inherently, there is a fear of inadequacy. There is an anxiety that their flaws will be discovered and that the truth that they are really not good enough will be revealed in time. There is an idea that to be less than perfect is to show vulnerability, which is ultimately a sign of weakness. When someone feels vulnerable, it's a sign of weakness. Now, how does this connect to anxiety in any way? So let's go into this a little bit. As far as the connection with anxiety, so many perfectionists have a certain checklist. When that checklist is not met, they feel inadequate, unhappy, and they get down on themselves. Next thing you know, that standard is so high. And when it's not consistently met, anxiety grows, panic grows, depression grows. Now, with this comes a couple of very important ways to overcome perfectionism. Number one, we must learn how to be vulnerable. Perfectionists have to learn how to be vulnerable. The common misconception about vulnerability is that, again, it is a sign of weakness. In reality, vulnerability is the key to growth, authenticity, and fulfillment, my friends. It is a sign of strength and courage. That's the truth, because anxiety sufferers, especially health anxiety sufferers, have a very difficult time being vulnerable. They want answers to the symptoms that they're feeling now, not later, but now. They view the symptoms as being life-threatening, not uncomfortable, when in fact they're uncomfortable, sometimes mightily uncomfortable, but still uncomfortable. When anxiety sufferers begin to embrace vulnerability, what they do is they give up control, something that many perfectionists today have a very difficult time doing. But in their lives, in different aspects of their lives, they need to be reminded that they did give up control and everything turned out just fine. You don't need the answers to each and every symptom that you feel. You don't need to entertain each and every negative or limiting thought that shows up. You can choose what thought to entertain and what thought to not entertain, to let go. Now, we must learn how to be vulnerable. We must begin placing ourselves in situations that create this vulnerability, and we must begin to prove to ourselves through a history of success that it's okay, that it's fine, that I can live this way, that I can still be successful, still loved, and still love myself, even when I feel vulnerable. But it must come through experience, because the brain learns the fastest and the best through experience. The second way that we're going to begin dealing with perfectionism that is causing someone to feel this anxiety is to recognize which perfectionistic standards and beliefs are problematic and evaluate them logically. My friends, we've got to get the rational mind organized here. We have to get it active. We've got to get it going, because we have to begin evaluating these sorts of thoughts, these sorts of beliefs that have not been updated. There hasn't been the process of what's called maturation. Since you were a child, maturation is the process where you begin updating your core beliefs, updating your behaviors, updating you from when you were a child. There is no update. So we must evaluate how these beliefs are problematic in our lives. How being perfect, how trying to maintain this perfectionist standard is not helping but hindering different parts of our lives. When you sit down and make this list and really evaluate how this is affecting you, you're going to find that you've got to start letting go. You've got to start letting go. And letting go doesn't mean you don't love your mom and dad anymore. It means, mom, dad, this way of thinking and believing in these things do not help me in my life anymore. It's giving me the opposite of what I truly want, and what I truly want is good health. I want to be vibrant. I want to be fulfilled. I want to be happy. And keeping these sorts of perfectionistic standards are not giving me that, mom. I still love you. Number three is stop comparing. We have to stop comparing. With so many social media apps, unrealistic advertising and media out there, it's impossible to not compare your life with an idealized sample of others. For perfectionists, it's not easy to remember to take a step back and assess reality. when we engage in comparisons, we typically measure ourselves next to someone we already think is better in some way. This comparing cycle must stop today. The only person that you should be comparing yourself to is the person that used to believe that what they believe is correct. Back in the day, childhood, teen years, 20s, whatever it may be, you believe certain things about yourself and the world. Now you must begin challenging those beliefs. You must begin comparing your new character to your old character and to ask yourself the question of, have I updated myself? Have I updated myself? And this updating will then take some time to then become an autopilot, to become the default mode internally. The system, your inner system, will not accept something that's new instantly. It will take time. This is where a lot of people fail because perfectionists step into that cold lake of water and it doesn't feel good. So they take a few extra steps. And they're very uncomfortable with this idea and these thoughts and these beliefs and these behaviors. And they scramble back to shore because it doesn't feel right. My friends, you must go through temporary pain to gain long-term fulfillment. And the truth is that, let me remind you one very important thing before I leave you today. From one recovering perfectionist to another, you are worthy and strong and beautiful, and you have so many talents and qualities. Use those talents and qualities for good, my friend. Don't abuse them through perfectionism. I love you so much. You are more than anxiety. Bye-bye.
Thanks for being an important part of the Anxiety Guy podcast community. If you enjoyed this podcast, please leave a positive rate and review. If you're searching for further support on your road to recovery from anxiety, head over to anxietyexit.com and take part in the powerful End the Anxiety program based around the CBT model. If you're searching for a more one-on-one approach, you can sign up now for personal coaching sessions with Dennis via Skype. Remember, you are more than anxiety. See you in the next episode.